So, in the previous class, we were discussing about sigmatropic reactions, right? So, we broadly classify sigmatropic reactions as 1N and as well as NM sigmatropic reactions. 1N, we said that the residue will move from the first position to the nth position, and NM rearrangement, we focus like it will be the movement of your sigma bond across your pi system. Then in 1N system, we again broadly classify that as hydrogen movement system and carbon migration system. So, we were dealing about hydrogen shift. So, what we studied there, we studied like reactions like 1,3, 1,5 and 1,7, and then we slowly got into their stereochemistry. So, stereochemistry may we studied two things, right? One, it should be suprafacial or it can be ultrafacial. Then we add this Woodward-Hoffmann rule for your 1N hydrogen shift. So, we said that we will take 4N, 4N plus 2. I am talking about the number of electrons involved. It will be pi system as well as sigma electrons. Then I said heating, and in the light, we said it will be ultrafacial and will be suprafacial, and just it will be opposite to this. So, what I mean is that if I take 1,5 system, okay, 1,5 hydrogen system, so it will be 6 electron systems. So, 6 electron system, if I heat it, I might end up with a suprafacial, and on the light, it will be ultrafacial. And if it is a 1,7 system, it will be other way around. But there was one thing you have to remember, which is that 1,3 shift. Okay. In 1,3, normally you do not observe any type of reactions on heating. Yeah, when it is light, then you can see suprafacial, but on heating, you do not see the any type of reactions, you do not see 1,3 hydrogen shift. We will just see why it is. Okay. R prime, better to write it so that our system like this, which is an with an hydrogen. Now, if I heat this, what happens? So, by theoretically, I should expect a 1,3 hydrogen shift, right? So, if you feel this, how this reaction goes, just for an assumption that it the bond cleaves here, okay, we think like it goes by a sort of radical. Okay. It is not completely, because it pericyclic goes by transition state. Okay. If you for assumption, if you feel that reaction goes like this way, like get an cation, then you can write as H plus. This can give you the product. If you feel this goes. Now, so I am dealing with this system. Okay. This is what? This is an allylic cation, right? So we are concerning about the heat. So, what we have to, which orbital we will be looking into it? We will be looking into the HOMO of allylic cation, right? just we draw the Ohm-Hoff allylic cation, how it looks like. One way of doing writing it in a proper way is that you have an R. R prime, okay. That's my attitude. Okay, so this is my allylic cation which I have taken the HOMO of it, okay, 1,3, and this is my hydrogen, okay. Now, if you see this reaction, what happens? It has to go and if I has to shift, it has to shift like this, but if you see it is orbitally not favored, right. So, superficially it cannot do the process because it is orbitally not favored. That is the rule. Again, the rule, if you put this in that Woodward-Hoffman rule, it says yes, it should not be a superficial, right. That also matches with your orbital one, okay. Now, what I do is that same system. So, this is your hydrogen. So, what the rule says? The rule says it can be under a phase shear. So, it can do an inversion to come here, okay. So, your hydrogen can do, but this is if you see orbitally it is favored, but what happens, your hydrogen is very small, okay. It cannot bind, it cannot do this binding because it is very small. That is why intrafacially also does not occur. Even it is orbitally favored, you can say geometrically it is unfavored. Because hydrogen is very small, so it cannot bridge between this two orbitals. That is the only one exception which comes for this rule. Otherwise, it just everything fits to that rule, okay. 1,3, 1,5, 1,7, all this fit exactly. Only in 1,3, if you go for your heating, both superficial and intraficial does not occur. See, if you see the same system photochemically, so what happens? In light. So, in light I will be taking the LUMO of allylic cation. So, how to draw the LUMO then? So, this will be the LUMO of your allylic cation, you have your hydrogen, fine. Now, in light it can easily do this, it can move superficially because you see orbitally it is favored, it can just move from this to this end superficially, fine. So, same thing you can do for your 1,5, 1,7 everything. So, this is orbitally favored as well as geometrically favored. So, the reaction happens nice, okay. So, that is what 1,3, 1,5 and 1,7. Only one thing to remember, 1,3 normally people ask this question all the time. Why 1,3 doesn't happen on heating? Okay, the reason is that 1,3 by if you heat it geometrically, it is not favored because the hydrogen nucleus is very small to make a bridge between this. This point you have to remember. Okay, fine. So that's about your 1N hydrogen shift. Okay, so now we will move to your 1N carbon shift. If methyl moves, then usually it's a methyl shift. Okay. We'll start with a simple example. Eat this. So you get a, so this will be 1, 2, and 3. You have a nice methyl. Okay. So you can call this as 1,3, right? Because it moved from 1 to third position. So you call it as 1,3. And here you can call them as methyl shift. 1,3 methyl shift. Fine. So same way you can draw for your 1,5 and 1,7 as you did for your hydrogen shift. Now then comes your stereochemistry into question, whether this will be suprafacial or it will be intrafacial. See, if you just take a methyl system, okay, then what happens, you can write the same rule for your Woodward-Hoffmann, like I can write just like your hydrogen shift. This also obeys your similar like your hydrogen shift. Initially it will be intrafacial 4N, then it will be supra 4N+2, just reverse of it. See, just similar to your hydrogen shift when it is methyl. Okay, keep that in mind when it is methyl. Any doubt up to this? Okay. See, the one interesting aspect comes in this carbon shift, that is that, for example, I have a system. Okay, I have a system like this. Now what happens, your carbon is sort of chiral. Okay, I am taking as a carbon. Previously I said it is only a methyl shift where your carbon has 3 hydrogens. Now I am slowly introducing another concept where your carbon becomes sort of a chiral. Now what happens if you look the stereochemistry, what it can happen? First you will say that how it will be suprafacial. Yeah, what are the options you can write on? One, I can say I can write suprafacial. Okay, keeping in mind now my chiral carbon, okay, can be in retention. One, it should be in retention. One option is there. Okay, I can say suprafacial retention. Can you draw that? Because it is a 1,5 hydrogen shift. Can you draw this 1,5 hydrogen? Just okay. Sorry. and then you get a B, then you get a B, then you have your C, okay. Just try to draw this supraficial retention, as I want to see. Just I will come back, I will take a new paper. You guys try it. What are the things you can draw? See, I have a D. Superficial retention. Write your A, B, because it has been shifted from here, then you write your C here, D. Now, make sure that your carbon which you are writing, okay, this is what? Now, your carbon has been having the same configuration, that is retention. So, another option can I write? Superficial inversion, okay. You can think about superficial inversion can also happen. No, we are just saying that what are the possible options can be. Right, I can have an inversion. Then what we can think about? So, I have a superficial retention, superficial inversion, and then I can write anyone. I can write intraofficial, yeah, very good. You can write intraofficial retention, okay. So, intraofficial retention will be just in the down, right, with the carbon. So, C and D will be up and your methyl will be in the down, okay. And then you can write your intraofficial inversion. See, in once it comes to a carbon, which is type of, which is a chiral, then you have to think about these four possibilities. So, one, it can be superficial retention, superficial inversion, intraofficial retention and intraofficial inversion. See, most of the time, okay, if you do, you get superficial retention. When it is superficial, most of the time it will be retention, okay. If it is an intraofficial, then it will be inversion, okay. This superficial inversion and intraofficial retention more or less are same. So, you have cases where you can get superficial inversion, this cases, this have comes only in one case, if you take the rule. Most of the time you will end up with superficial, if it is superficial, it will be retention. If it is intraofficial, it will be inversion, clear? Now, what we will do, we just take that Woodward-Hoffman rule, which we wrote earlier for methyl shift. That is 4N plus 2 heating H. What we said? We said initially it will be intraofficial, okay, then it will be superficial, then superficial, intraofficial. So, what we found out, if it is a carbon with a chiral, if it is intraofficial, it should be inversion, right. So, I can put A plus I. If it is suprafacial, it should be retention, because it is suprafacial, there will be no change in your chirality. So, it will be S plus R. Fine. Now, I just add one term into your carbon shift. If it is a just a methyl shift, no need to worry, it will be similar to your hydrogen shift. But if your carbon is a chiral, then you have to understand whether it is an inversion or it is a retention. Fine. So, the rule can be done like this. For 4N, it will be A plus I or S plus R, 4N plus 2 S plus R or A plus I. Clear? Any doubt here? Okay. See, as we said in hydrogen shift, for 1,3 hydrogen shift, when you heat it, there is an exception that it does not undergo any reaction. Okay. Same way for carbon. Okay. for 1,3 heating, it does not follow this rule, whatever rule we have written. So, we will just see what it happens in that case. For example, I take our 1,3, just sigmatropic carbon shift, just taking 1,3. Okay. For example, just we will take the methyl for simple representation, you will understand later why it. So, it is a 1,3 shift. You know it goes by allylic cation, as I earlier said, if I break this. Okay. Shall we draw the OMO of this? Because I am doing in heating. So, I am just considering the OMO of allylic cation. So, how the OMO looks? It should be just the opposite, right? Lopes. Now, I have to put my carbon. Sorry, I have to put this. Now, you have your. Okay, I will just put your carbon here. Fine. Okay. Now, you know that this is not going to happen. Fine. So, what the rule says? So, it will be ultrafacial inversion, right. See, the according to rule, it should be, it should make an ultrafacial inversion. Yeah, looks like to be, because it says it can be, but this methyl is so nice, instead of doing this big thing, what it does, it simply invert itself here. If you just see this, how it is easy for this guy to do this. So, it is so nice to see how these guys work. See what it did, is just inverted itself. Okay. Now, it can do easily suprafacial, right. Why it has to do now ultrafacial? Because the orbital is favored. See, actually by rule it should go ultrafacial inversion, right. But what happened in this case? You get suprafacial inversion. So, this is the only one case I think you get suprafacial inversion. Most of the case, if you say you will be dealing with suprafacial retention and antrafacial inversion, yeah, because antrafacial may you get inversion, suprafacial it maintains. So, this is the only case where you get suprafacial inversion. So, but keep that in mind. Yeah, see, I am just taking for an example, simpler. If it is x, y, z, it will be clear, but we are not seeing the difference because, but actually it happens suprafacially inversion. You are not, it happens like that. We are not observing by the product.
But because if so, it is not methyl, but instead of methyl.
Yeah, if you have a chiral carbon, definitely you can observe. It will do suprafacial inversion, yes, and you can clearly observe that from the product. Yeah, it is only for 1,3 sigma tropic shift, that also particularly in heating. So, this heating 1,3 heating in both the case, hydrogen as well as carbon, does not fit exactly with your rule. Okay. That only point you have to remember. Clear? Any doubt with this? No. So, shall we get into problems? So, we will do some problems on 1N sigma tropic shift. Next, say examples or I say problems. When you write this, the stereochemistry is very important because you are going to talk about so I have a system like this. Okay, just I am going to photolyze. So now first thing you have to find out whether what shift it is. Okay. The second thing you have to find out the stereochemistry, right? Because I am defining my hydrogen. So, what shift you are going to, because it is photolysis, I have defined the condition. So, H mu, which is possible 1,3, H mu 1,3 is very fast. Okay. See 1,5 heating matter, 1,7 again H mu, because these are all orbitally favored one. So, you can do then 1,3 hydrogen shift. The second question is that whether it will be antrafacial or suprafacial. So, what the rule says? What system it is? It is 4N. So, light it is S, right? Suprafacial. So, first you write that, then write the product once you finish it. So, it is 1,2,3, right. So, your hydrogen will be same phase. Okay. Simple example, but tells you what happens. Clear? A system like this. Now, I am saying that I am going to heat it. What you can think of heating the system. see, you have an option, if you count, you have 1,3 and you have 1,5, that is all. So, it should be 1,3 or 1,5, and I am giving eating. You are just seeing which is orbitally favored, your 1,5 is favored. Okay. So, it undergoes a nice 1,5 hydrogen shift. So, 1,5 heating, what it is? Antra or supra? Suprafacial. Just keep that formulae into your mind. So, then I can write the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right. So, it is a suprafacial right, you can get this. Any doubt? Again, you can, if you eat this, what happen? I can again eat this. Again, you will end up same 1,5 hydrogen shift, but not the same product, but same chemistry. 1,5 hydrogen shift suprafacially. Write the product. Number it and write the product. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. My hydrogen can come here. Very good examples to work on. Which movement? No, hydrogen moves very, very fast comparatively. That's good. Yeah, deuterium also can move. Okay, so we don't need to go by one by examples. Okay, we'll just change. Otherwise, it looks like easy to find out. So, now I heat this. What do you look for? See, the hydrogen OAC are one side, okay, deuterium and nitrogen on other sides. So, this is OACs, O-acetyl. Hydrogen, this is your hydrogen, deuterium, OAC, and hydrogen. So, what do you observe? Now, I heat this guy. Or if I photolyze, whatever, if we did just heat it, what you can think about? There is no hydrogen. You are thinking about hydrogen shift. Yeah, you can think about your carbon shift, na? 1, 2, 3. Okay. This carbon can shift. Na? So it will be 1,3 carbon shift. So what it is? What the rules is? It will be an inversion, right? So, can you write it? So, it should be inversion, keep that in mind. So, if I will be happy if you write the structure before me, because it will be, I want to know how you see this particular carbon when it moves, because it is undergoing a inversion. So, I know that you will write this part, okay, but I will be much interested to see how you write this. Okay. So, you have a OAC this side, okay, and you have an hydrogen here, that is fine, because it says same like that. What happened this side now? What will happen to this hydrogen and deuterium? It will be other way around, because you are inverting, right. So, now you can write your deuterium here and you can write your hydrogen. See, that is how you should know, because this inversion and retention is very big in writing the stereochemistry. It is not only about hydrogen shift or methyl shift or 1,3 or 1,5 or 1,7, it should be with your stereochemistry, fine. Any doubt? Take another good example here, see whether you guys can write this, the same one, but OAC, okay. Just I am taking the same example, just want to see again how you write this, the way different way I am. Is it just the same one, right? See, that is what I am saying, the way of projection, it is the same example, the way of projection is like this, okay. So, do not think like when it is projected, you see that this is the different example, okay. It is the same example, that is what I want to know. So, when you write, you can open up this and then also you can draw your stereochemistry, okay. Same way for this product, if you write another way, see I am just, it is, can say it is 3, the same way I am writing it. Now, whichever way you like, you can open it up and I am seeing people writing like this also, it is also good way of representation, right. Same example, different way of writing it up, the same compound. So, you should know the many ways of seeing the molecules, that is why I just want to write this one, fine. Now, we will take one good example, which is your test for Woodward-Hoffmann. See, you take this example, okay. If you heat this, for example, what you should get? I take this example and I heat it. So, it is 1,5, right, because it is very clearly says it is 1,5. 1,5 heating is what? Suprafacial, right. Yeah. So, can you draw the structure? So, it is simple. So, it is suprafacial, so get the hydrogen. So, it should be what if I number it R, this is R, Z and E, right, okay. See what happens with this compound, once you do the heating, I get another product which is S, Z and Z also along with this. So, I get R Z E, I am getting S Z Z, that means I am getting different stereochemistry, right, stereoisomer. So, how it is possible, any idea? 6-membered. If I just eat, I get RZ, that is, you say it is 1,5 hydrogen shift with a supraphasia. Are you thinking, for getting this, are you thinking like intrafacial? But intrafacial never happens in 1,5. Yeah. So, what happens there? What happened to this molecule? If you take in solution this molecule, see this molecule does very nice CC bond rotation, single bond rotation, right. So, you this is get methyl, you can have other way around. So, it just it can do a CC bond rotation, that is possible, right. And this in 1,5 undergoes 1,5 hydrogen shift suprafacially, it will give you the other product, which is SZE, that is what? See the nice way of writing it. So, these are all things you should know, okay. I am taking one molecule, so it undergoes a CC bond rotation, so it can give this, and these are all the options which you have to open when you do this type of examples. So, suddenly do not break the rule and say, no sir, it might also go inversion, so I will get this product, okay. It does not happen that. We'll take another molecule. This molecule you have to save, because where you have studied this molecule in lot of places. Any idea where you are? Oh, sorry, you have a methyl there. 1,2 methyl here. You have a methyl there, okay. You have studied this synthesis. Where it studied? It does, then it does a electrocyclic ring closure, you end up in sort of a vitamin.
Vitamin D.
You study this in vitamin D synthesis, right. What shift you study there? See this, if I do a photolysis, see when people ask, they ask like this only, okay. Photolysis, what do you expect? This cis trans and sigma tropic, any sigma tropic reactions? Any sigma tropic, that we are dealing with sigma tropic only. We are dealing with right now with hydrogen shift or methyl shift. Anything comes in your mind? See, if I write this hydrogen, then suddenly things comes to your mind. If I write hydrogen like this, what happens? 1,7. See, if I don't write that hydrogen, then you have to think. Yeah, see, if you have methyl, just please write the hydrogens, then it is easy to find out. Now, it will be nice 1,7 shift, okay. You can write 1,2,3,4,5,6,7. the nice 1-7 hydrogen shift. So what is that, antraofficial or supraofficial? That is very important. So 1-7 hydrogen shift. So what your rule says? Superficial. 1-7. One seven is what? One seven is what system? What electron system?
4N
system. Heating me, it's superficial. Just because this geometry is little bit unfavored for superficial, it should be. Let's check it up. I will get back to this regarding the configuration. So, because this geometry is little bit favored, looks like to be an antraofficial. Okay, looks to be antraofficial geometry. I will get back to you in explanation. Okay. Okay. Okay, I have a system like this now. So now I say that I need other way around. I say that this chemistry goes superficially retention. Okay, what it says? I'm saying that superficially. Double bond. Oh, example 5, okay, okay, sorry. Yeah, sure. We need a double bond because you shift this, you shift that. Yeah, right? So I want this reaction. This reaction goes by superficial retention. Okay. So tell me what condition it is. Other way around. This is superficial retention, this geometry. So, what condition shall I use? Because first you find out what shift it will be. What shift you want to do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right. So, I can move this carbon. So, it will be 1-5 shift. So, 1-5, if I want superficial retention, what I have to do? Heat it or I have to photolyze?
Heat it.
See, that is other way of finding out. Okay. See, one way I can ask you that heat, what you get? Other way I can ask you that this is the geometry I got. So, find out the condition. Okay. You should do other way around also. So, on heating, now you just draw the structure. So, it should be. Metal here. Okay. So, further also you can do this same way. Then what you get? Again, same, right? Any doubt with these systems now? So you can do any examples then? Okay. Now I will give you one example which you guys to try to do. I have a system like this, okay. I have many combinations here. So I say that I am just stipulating it for heating. What do you want to do? Heating. So, 1, 5, what? 1, 5, there are two choice, methyl or hydrogen. I can push my methyl, I can push my hydrogen. What do you want to do? Yeah, 1, 5, hydrogen shift. Very good. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, now you know how right, you have your hydrogen here. So now we have. You have a conditions. So, you see, if an example is given, you have to find out the condition. Okay. If the condition is known, then you find out whether it is 1, 5, 1, 3, 1, 7. Then you find out whether it is suprafacial or intrafacial. Then you find out whether it is a retention or inversion. Any doubt with this examples? Okay. So we will stop your 1N hydrogen shift. That is all on 1N hydrogen shift. So, we will be then concentrating on NM sigmatropic reactions. Clear? Yeah.